experts in an examination point of view are important. Usually, when we go for statement problems, we face some confusions. Illana vandu rendu meaning varamadhiri irukku. So in that situation, how we have to handle. So it's like end of the conceptual session where we discuss also like a summary session, but we discuss everything in short, like so that the twist words or the useful hints will be helpful for the solving, right? First one, you know that total property is always equal to 1, right? Total property is always equal to 1. So let me have the workings here. Total property is always equal to 1. That is summation of all the probability values equal to 1, right? We say that P of A plus P of A complement is equal to 1. Sometimes, we'll be taking as P of A union B plus P of A union B, the whole dash is also equal to 1. Right, understand? A union B, no? Either A or B happens. When I go for A and B not happens, that is neither A nor B happens. We use the term called as this one as neither A nor B happens. Neither A nor B. Probability of not happening of both A and B. So neither A nor B happens. Now we have to find this value. Now we will take the help of total probability theorem. So this will be done as P of A union B, the whole dash is equal to 1 minus P of A union B. Is it okay? P of A union B. Else you can do as this. What is A union B, the whole dash? Taking the help of De Morgan's law, A dash intersection B dash, right? So you can do it this way also. So A dash means not happening of A, B dash means not happening of B, and this one is AND. So neither A happens nor B happens. Neither A nor B. So we can take the help of total property. So usually total property is equal to 1. Sometimes, usually many get confused. If we add the two values of the property, they get greater than 1. See, this is not at all possible. Always it will be equal to 1 only. It cannot exceed 1. இல்ல மேம் நான் ஒரு சில ப்ராப்ளம் பண்ணியிருக்கோம் ரெண்டு ப்ராபபிலிட்டி வேல்யூ ஆட் பண்ணா கிரேட்டர் தென் 1 வருதே மேம் எந்த கேஸ்ல பார்க்கலாம் ஓகே தட் இஸ் தி வே யூ ஹேவ் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் இஸ் குவைட் டிஃபரண்ட் நவ ஐ த்ரோ அ டை ஐ த்ரோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டை ஐ த்ரோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டை அண்ட் ஐ அக்செப்ட் அண்ட் ஐ எக்ஸ்பெக்ட் அ நம்பர் which is 1/6 right which is 1/6 ஐ த்ரோ செகண்ட் டை அண்ட் ஐ எக்ஸ்பெக்ட் a number and the probability is 1/6. This probability is space die 1, this is die 2. Okay. In the way add pannina ungalku the final value is 2/6 now. In case instead of getting 1, getting any phase greater than 2 nu vechikalam. Greater than any 2, that is getting any phase greater than 2. Which means that 3 is favorable, 4 is favorable, 5 is favorable, 6 is favorable. First 4 items are phase of favorable, so this will be 4/6. Whereas the second day you are expecting any value less than or equal to 2 or less than or equal to 3 in which less than or equal to 3, then 1 is favorable, 2 is favorable, 3 is favorable, 3/6. They give the answer as 7/6, which is greater than 1 so long. Which is greater than 1 so long. No, the concept you have understood here is wrong. What you are doing here is right, 4/6. What I am doing here is like 3/6, but you are going to add here both the values to get 7/6. No, you have to understand the question. If the first die of 4/6 is no, that's regarding the first die only. See, if it is 4/6, what is complementary of this 2/6, right? See, for me, add 1 or 1 more. If this is 3/6, what is the complementary of this 1 minus 3/6? 3/6, see, if you add, you will get 1. So total property will never exceed 1. So if you have 1 to the power, you have to understand the concept. There may be something over there, right? There may be something over there. So first one is done. Let me go for the second one. Represent probability value in fractions or decimals or verdicts. Yes. Sometimes we represent in fractions is, see what we are doing here is 1/6 or 3/6 or whatever. It is fractions. In decimals we will express what is this 3/6 is 0.5. What is this 1/6 is 0.1/6, right? 1/6, 0.142. So it will come in 0.1 some value. Okay, it is in decimals. But what happens in the case of wordings is probably you may find a case where five shots are there and you expect to kill the bird in three shots. Try to understand. Totally five shots are there and you expect to kill the bird in three shots, which means that the probability value that you can kill the bird is 3/5. For killing the bird, for not killing the bird is 2/5 now. Or they will give us 1 out of 5 shots. Not 3 out of 5 shots. Here is 3 shots, right? 3 out of 5 shots. 3 out of 5 shots. In this case, 3 out of 5 shots, the 3/5 is the probability value. It will be given in wordings, right? So we will have in fractions, decimals, and also in wordings. It depends on, you have to understand the question. Third one. And then all, yes, it's quite famous with set theory. When I say and, the word and, or when I say the word or, and stands for multiplication. So this is and, we use this one also. And stands for multiplication, whereas or stands for addition, right? In the set theory we have discussed and stands for intersection, or stands for union, yes. And when we go for A intersection B, A intersection B is nothing. Intersection is of the format multiplication, so that I shall present directly as AB itself, right? AB itself. When I go for A plus B, which means it's union, right? So if you can write the addition theorem as like this, you can write the addition theorem like this. P of, you know the addition theorem, P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection. We know this is the addition theorem. Now I am going to try representing in this way. Okay, so this will be P of A union B. This P of A plus B equal to P of A, right? P of B, right? Minus P of A, B, right? The case of multiplication theorem. We have P of A B is equal to P of A into P of independent events on the B given here. Yes? Independent events are the P of A into P of B. So you have to understand, if it is given as A, B, na, A intersection B, na, so you have to understand this one, right? So this is with respect to 3. So 2 is over and 3 is over. Let me go for the fourth one, addition theorem. Yes, this is very important. Addition theorem is used, but in that, if it is given mutual exclusive, na, what happens? See, this is the addition theorem, right? This is the addition theorem. If they say A and B are mutually exclusive, right? If they say A and B are mutually exclusive, what happens? If they say A and B are mutually exclusive, then this becomes 0. A happens or B happens, that is both will not happen. So this will become 0. So in that case, if it is mutually exclusive, we will present it as P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B, 0. So you can just leave it. In case, where you are going to use multiplication theorem, that is A and B are independent events. A and B are independent events. Okay. A and B are independent events. In that case, we'll write this theorem addition as shift theorem as P of A and B equal to P of A. Right? P of B plus P of B minus P of, this will be taken help from multiplication theorem, which is P of A into P of B. So I'll open a bracket or represent P of A into P of A. So you have to keep this in your mind. How will I identify this? I have to take 0 or this, I have to take this one. P of A to P of A. Your question will be like, there is Mr. X who attends the interviews and the probability that he may be selected is 3/5. And there is Mr. Y, he also attends the interview and the probability that he may be selected will be 2 or some 4/10. Okay, this is the other. Okay, 4/10. So what is the probability that either A or B is selected, or either X or Y is selected? See, X is a different person, Y is a different person. There is no connection here. Independent is a rule. Okay, in the money case, now we use this one. Okay, we use this one, right? So this is with respect to addition theorem, taking the help of sometimes mutually exclusive, sometimes independent events. Sometimes independent events. So please be careful with this, right? This is 4. Fifth one is very important. Fifth one is very important. I will discuss one in group, two persons solving a game. Person solving a problem. When they say or when they use the words problem is solved, see, try to understand, problem is solved. So we call it, two persons are solving a great game. There may be situations where both not solving, both not solving. So A dash, B dash, right? Which means A dash intersection B dash. A solves, B does not. Idhar case aata. Else this can be A not solving, B solves. Idhar case aata. Mila both solves. Idhar case aata. Okay. Only these four cases will be available. Both not solving, A solves but does not B solves, A does not solve but B solves, and A and B both solves. Right? In the case where it will be like the problem is solved. What is the probability that the problem is solved? If the problem is solved now, this is favorable because A is solving here. This is favorable because B is solving here. And obviously this one is favorable because A and B are solving here. Appa idu varadu. Okay, idu varadu. Right? So what you can do here is you can find probability of this one or A, yeah, probability of this one or probability of this one. So P of AB plus P of A dash B plus P of AB dash. You can take this one. Or we know the total probability is equal to 1. If you take a probability of all this one, it will be equal to 1. So to find this value, what I'll do is I'll do 1 minus this other values. Okay, the other values are A union B. Correct? The values are put together. Is what you call as these values put together, what you call as A union B. What is A union B? Either A source or B source. In both sources are no issues. Okay, you can present it as P of A union B or 1 minus this value. Okay, 1 minus this value for not solving, both not solving. Okay, 1 minus this value. 1 minus the value for the value. Because you need not find each and every value and add, right? These are three different cases. You have to find probability value for all these and add. So it seems like a lengthy problem. So either one of find one is less than 1. So 1 minus not both solving. Or you can take this case. Okay. So this will be asked, right? What is the probability that the problem will be solved? So it will be like this. Problem will be solved. It will be the gateway problem. Problem is solved or will be solved. What is the probability that the problem is solved? In the monthly case, you can go for any one of the three options, right? So this is with respect to fifth one, right? Now, let me go for the sixth one. Probability in terms of combinations, yes. There is a bag containing six balls, or there is a bag containing six white and five black balls. You had to pick one ball, you had to pick two balls. In the long run, and where the balls will be replaced or not replaced. So both the cases will be discussed together. So sixth one is probability in terms of combinations will discuss, and whereas balls or some cards or whatever it is, whether replaced or not replaced, let me discuss both together here. So let me go here with respect to 6th and 7th one. So if you have a basket or a bag containing 6 white and 5 black balls, which you have 5 black balls, you are going to pick 2 balls here. You are going to pick 2 balls here. In the sense, totally 11 balls are here, you are going to pick 2 balls. And that 2 balls are expected to be white balls for chicken. So this will be done as 6C2 divided by 11C2. Which means, calculation should be made easier. 6C2 is 6 into 5 divided by 2 factorial. The whole divided by 11 into 10 divided by 2 factorial. Am I right? Anyhow, you are going to cancel this one. 2 factorial and 2 factorial. So which are the values of the one? So what I say is, instead of doing 6 into 5 divided by 2 factorial, 11 into 10 divided by 2 factorial, what you can do is directly you can write it as 6 into 5 by 11 into 10. Right? If you are attending a objective problem, these useful hints will be very much helpful for solving the problem in a very quick manner. So 6C2 by 11C2 is 6 into 5 divided by 11. You need not go for cancelling and all. If you cancel it, you will the answer is 3 by 11. Okay, you need not go and cancel. Once you see this is the question, 6 into 5, 30 divided by 11 into 10. So you can do it easily. So it will be easier, 110. So this is with respect to calculation. Okay, focus on the calculation. Calculation, try to make it easier, right? Anyway, because you have 2 and 2 here. Appa dhaan neenga cancel panna mudiyum. Because you have 2 and 2, you can cancel. And it will be given 2 or 3 cards drawn at random. Yes. Neenga oradi pick panna mudiyum 2 or 3 cards edukringa. Or 3 or 2 or 3 balls edukringa. So in that case, what you will do is first to draw like there are two draws where you take two balls. Well, two balls are taken at random. konjam careful ah paanga taken at random. This may be a case. What happens here now is two draws. So first draw and another draw. Two draws are in, right? First draw and second. First draw and second. When two balls are taken at random, so when you go for picking first draw, it will you'll go for picking up two balls. Now, the first one, the white balls are chitona. For example, white balls are chitona. This will be 6C2 divided by 11C2, right? And in case if I go for drawing the second draw with respect to black balls for chitona, now comes here whether replacement is done or not replacement, not replaced or replacement is done. If nothing is mentioned in the question, if nothing is mentioned in the question, we take that it is not replaced. We take that it is not replaced. Please try to understand. Question the mention பண்ணிருந்தாதான் நீங்க என்னன்னு பார்க்கணும். If nothing is mentioned in the question, take it as not replaced. Take it as not replaced. அப்ப if nothing is mentioned here na not replaced na to then what will happen is instead of 11 balls na already 2 balls are taken out, now there will be only 9 balls. So we'll find the change in the total. We'll find the change in the total. So you have total changes in case of no replacement. In case of no replacement, right? So no replacement done in the question la kudukna avasiyam illa. Nothing is mentioned. See, no mention. Nothing is mentioned in the question. We assume this is not replaced, right? No replacement. Adina enatho total change aagum. Is it okay? Total change. So 6C2 divided by 11C2. Okay, 6C2 divided by 11C2. And nothing is mentioned in the question, so it's not replaced. Upon in the next black balls draw on over here, 5 are there, so 5C2 divided by, instead of 11, now total changes to 9, so this is 9C2. Okay. You may face some case where you're going to draw, one white and one black balls. In this case, how many are here? 6 are here. So 6C1, because you're going to draw only one white and so multiplication. Black balls is 5, so 5C1 divided by 11C2. Please focus here. Total number of balls to be drawn is 2 balls, so 11C2. And you have to draw one white and one black. So for one white is 6C1 and for one black it is 5C1. Is it okay? So this is with respect to 6 and 7. This is with respect to 6 and 7. Is it okay? Fine. Let me go for the 8th one. Yes, this is quite famous. Number of evens. Total number of evens in a sample space. Okay, power. Coins are on the will take 2 power n and dice are on the will take 6 power n. You can take the help of Pascal's triangle. So let me do the working here. With respect to Pascal's triangle, yes, you are very much known of the Pascal's triangle. Pascal's triangle and coin tossing are on the one. So it will start with 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, right? X will be 1, 3, 3, right? You know the identity? A plus B the whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square, right? I take A value as 1 and B value as 1. 1 plus 1 the whole square. Okay, this is 1 square plus 2 into 1 into 1, 2 plus 1 square. So you get 1, 2, 1. See, you are getting 1, 2, 1. This one is 1, 2, 1. Okay, so what is the value of this one? 1, 2, 1 is 4, right? 4, right? What is 1 plus 1? 2. 2 square, 4. Okay. And if you go for 3 coins, that is power 3. 1 plus 1 power 3. So it will be 1 plus 3 plus 3 plus 1. 1 plus 3 plus 3 plus 1, which is 8. Yes, this is 2 power 3. This is how we can do it. The 1 and 1 in the game board run now, because with respect to coin tossing run board, we'll have it as head or tail as a money evens. Okay, that's why we have, with respect to coin tossing, we have 2 power 3. With respect to die throwing, we'll be having as what? 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus. Up 6 circle, yeah, 6 outcomes circle. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus. So up to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is power n. So 6 power n. So this is how we get points and dice. 6 power n. Is it okay? Fine. Ninth one. Number multiple or divisible. Shall I go? Number multiple or divisible. So if I find a number 45 and they say what is the probability that the number is divisible by 5 is longer, by 3 is longer. Okay, divisible by, there is multiple or they use the word multiple or divisible. Multiple. simple or digital. Whatever the case is, make it simple. How many, what's the probability that the number chosen between 1 to 45 is divisible or multiple by 4? Okay, I'll take the number 45. I'll take the help of calculator. 45 divided by 5 panipalanga is 9. So I can write as 5 into 9. So how many numbers are divisible or multiple by 9 here? Sorry, 5 here? 9. So your answer will be 9 by. So probability of number divisible by 5 will be 9 by 45. Why is 45? Total numbers are 1 to 45, so 45. Right. If it is with respect to 3 now, 45 can be written as 3 into 15. Take the help of a calculator. 45 divided by 3 is 15, so 15. So yeah, probability value for a number to be divisible by 3 is 15 by 45. Okay. Need not be 5 and 3. It can be 6. For example, 6. What happens here? 45 is equal to, with respect to 6 and 45. So this is 45 divided by 6 will be, you are getting the answer 6 into 7.5. Okay? 6 into 7.5. 7.5 means it leaves a reminder now. See, 6 into 7 is 42. Okay, 6 into 7 is 42. I take the reminder 3 so that I will make 45. Upon the 45 I will present for now, 6 into 7 plus 3 will present for now. So 6 is the answer. Sorry, 7 is the answer. So probability of a number to get a number divisible by 6 is 7 divided by 45. Is it okay? I shall check. 1 to 45 and then the numbers divisible by 6 are required. 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, 36, 42. So if you check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yes, 7 by 42. Yeah, ma'am, that's the direct time. Why I need to go for this calculation? Okay, if you have a small number, it's quite okay. If you have a number like 1 to 1000, you're going to work out sitting for all the 1000 numbers, need not earlier. So you can do 10 times 12 of this one. So this is number multiple or divisible. Is it okay? Now let me go for the 10th one, specific sample space. Yes, specific sample space. You will face this problem where instead of taking the help of conditional probability, but instead of doing it in an elaborated way, you can take the help of specific sample space. Probably a question may be like, a family has two children. Let me have a question. A family has two children. What is the probability that the chosen child is a boy? If it is known that there is already a boy. There is already a boy child, which means that two children are boy or girl. Am I right? What is the probability that the chosen child is a boy if it is known that there is already a boy? See, what is the normal sample space for things? With respect to two children, I may have the normal sample space. See, normal sample space is, can be taken as boy-boy or boy-girl or girl-boy or girl-girl. Am I right? எப்படி எடுக்கலாம்னா கேர்ள் கேர்ள் எடுக்கலாம் பாய் பாய் எடுக்கலாம் பாய் கேர்ள் எடுக்கலாம் கேர்ள் பாய் எடுக்கலாம் டோட்டலி ஃபோர் பட் இங்க வந்து என்ன ஆகுது தட்ஸ் ஆல்ரெடி எ பாய் னு சொல்லிருக்கோம் நவ ஐ கோ ஃபார் ஸ்பெஷல் கேஸ் ஆர் ஸ்பெசிபிக் சாம்பிள் ஸ்பேஸ் எஸ் வேர் மை சாம்பிள் ஸ்பேஸ் ஹியர் வில் பி ஹேவிங் ஆல்ரெடி எ பாய் அப்ப என்னன்னா எனக்கு இங்க எடுக்கணும் இட்ஸ் நாட் ஐ டாக்கிங் அபௌட் ஃபேவரபிள் ஈவென்ட்ஸ் ஐ டாக்கிங் அபௌட் ஸ்பெசிபிக் சாம்பிள் ஸ்பேஸ் வேர் இன் திஸ் கேஸ் மை சாம்பிள் ஸ்பேஸ் வில் நவ பி பாய் 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 கேர்ள் அண்ட் கேர்ள் ஓகே இப்போ கொஸ்டின் பாருங்க வாட்ஸ் த ப்ராப்ளம் தட் சோசன் சைல்ட் இஸ் அ பாய் சோசன் சைல்ட் இஸ் அ பாய் அப்போ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் என்ன இருக்கும் பாய் இருக்கும் ஓகே அப்போ இங்கேயும் பாய் இங்கேயும் பாய் இதுல இங்க பாய் இருக்கு பாய் இருக்கு பாய் இருக்கு தட்ஸ் வை தே சோசன் 3 பட் நவ தே சே வாட்ஸ் த ப்ராப்ளம் தட் சைல்ட் விச் ஐ சூஸ் இஸ் அ பாய் இஃப் இட்ஸ் நோட் ஆல்ரெடி தென் இஸ் அ பாய் அப்போ இதுல இந்த ரெண்டு பாய் தான் இருக்க முடியும் சோ மை ப்ராபபிலிட்டி ஃபார் திஸ் ஒன் இஸ் மை ப்ராபபிலிட்டி ஃபார் திஸ் ஒன் இஸ் ஓகே திஸ் ஒன் இஸ் 1 because only one is favorable to me boy irukku and inor right divided by 3 is it okay 1 divided by 3 this is normal problem ah panna irukum indha mari panna normal problem ah panna irukum what's the normal sample space 4 clear so so 4, right? So I have to take the probability as conditional probability. Probability of B given A is equal to probability of A intersection B divided by probability of A. Okay. A is already a boy. Okay. And B is probability that the chosen child is a boy. So this is B and this is given to B. Okay. So in this case, what is P of A? What is P of A? This one is A, right? Already a boy. So total 4 events, there are 4 events in total and already a boy, this will not come. So I have 3 favorable. So 3 by 4, am I right? Now come for this one, P of A intersection B. Okay, what is P of A intersection B? A is a boy, A is a boy and B is choosing a boy. So boy, boy, okay. Totally 4 events and 1 by 4. Do you understand? See, when I go for doing in an elaborated way, taking the help of conditional probability, I find P of B given A, where P, this is equal to P of A intersection B divided by P of A, right? Now in the case of P of A, this one is already a boy, the event which has happened first. Now already a boy, now all these 4 events are there, I put 4 in the denominator and boy in the case is nothing. So 3 by 4, so normal probability. Numerator P of A intersection B, A is already a boy and B is choosing a boy. But if there is a boy, this is the only case favorable, so 1 by 4. Now if I cancel it, you get it as 1 by 3. That's what we do. It was a specific sample space. So sample space is a specific part. So sometimes this may be helpful, this may be helpful, but you should not get confused. You know, elaborate on a poor amount of people. So you can take the help of specific sample space, right? So this is 10th part, right? Let me go for the 11th one. Probability space function. What is mean by probability space function? It's a function, nothing but function. Are there a probability space function now? We know about functions domain and codomain. So we have a set of domain values. So this side is a domain. And we have a set of codomain values. So this is CD, recognized as CD. Domain is nothing but a sample space. Domain is nothing but a sample space. For example, I'm going to toss 2 coins in a chicken. Okay, I'm going to toss 2 coins. So this will have head, head-tail, tail-head, tail-tail. Okay, this will be the sample space. And this will be mapped to head-head is 1 by 4. This is 1 by 4. This is 1 by 4. And this is 1 by 4. Is it okay? 1 by 4. You add all these. You get the value 1. In the mother map for the probability space function, where the domain will be the sample space, codomain will be the probability values. At the end of point note, if you add all these values, okay, range, add, you have to get the value 1. So in case, in the end of the twist, what are the usual twists you can face here? Okay, let us see. In the twist, the usual questions are the problem. What type of questions you can expect you? First one is under this one, probability samples function, probability space function, 11th one. Okay. First one is they will ask you to check whether this is a probability space function. They will ask you to check whether this is a probability space function or check one. I'm just writing as a PSF, which means you have to find all the probability values equal to 1. Check one. Probably there are 3 events A, B and C in which class. So it may be given probability of A is equal to 1 by 2, probability of B is equal to 1 by 4 and probability of C is equal to 1 by 4. Yes, add pretty far, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 is equal to 1. Yes, this is the probability function. Sometimes it may be given P of A is equal to 0, P of B equal to P of C is equal to half. 0 in the clock, yes in the clock. See, probability can take any value between 0 to 1, right? So this is the range of probability. It can take the value 0. So no issues. But P of B plus P of C add 1 of 1. Yes, P of B is half. P of C is half. So if you add P of A plus P of B plus P of C, yes, this is all equal to 1. Yes, this also can come over here. So this is how we can find out. So this is with respect to problem. That is point number 11. This will be point number 11. Let me go for the 12th one. Twist words, yes. If you have omit twist words, you should be very careful what it is given, what you have to do here, right? You may be facing parts, there are minimum two heads, maximum two heads, at most two heads, at least two heads. Then we go for taking with respect to three points. Okay, you know the sample space of the three points: head, 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 tail, 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 head, head, tail, right? Head, tail, head, and tail, head, head, right? Else you can take what? Tail, head, tail, or head, tail, tail, or tail, head, tail, tail. Is it okay? So you're getting 8. Yes. If you pass the triangle, you're putting 1, 3, 3, 1. You can easily present. Which means this is 0 heads, this is 1 head, this is 2 heads, and this is all 3 heads, right? Minimum 2 heads. Okay, my first one is minimum 2 heads. When I say minimum 2 heads, it can be 2 heads or more than 2 heads. So the probability of this will be minimum 2 heads. About this one and this one. So your value will be 4/0. In case it is at least 2 heads. Okay, at least 2 heads. Yes, there is no change in this. 2 heads, that time are 2 heads, 3 heads. So your answer will be 4/8. This is also okay. In case you have maximum 2 heads, please focus on this maximum 2 heads, which means that this is 2 heads. Maximum 2 heads, you cannot go with 3 heads. Apo 1 head irukla, 2 heads irukla, 0 heads irukla. So you can go with respect to 1 head and 2 heads. So this answer is 6/8. Konja careful apart from the fourth one. Probability of at most 2 heads. Here is a twist where you say at most 2 heads. Now you have to give focus with respect to 0 heads also. Quite important. Maximum now 1 head and 2 heads are considered. At most now you have to consider 0 heads plus 1 head plus 2 heads. So your answer will be 7/8. So quite important, please keep focus on this 7/8. And usually we will get the problem like less than or equal to, greater than or equal to. Please focus on this, because when you throw a die, they will say less than or equal to 2. 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6. They will say greater than, strictly greater than 2. Then you will not get 2. So you will get a Kafka problem. Or also you will get the finding sum of phases of 2 dice. So you will take 2 phases of the dice, you will notice the phases and you will find the sum greater than 7, less than 7, so you can go with that. Okay, fine. So this one is done, this one is done, this one. Yes, any one or one. So this is with respect to this problem. Okay, you can discuss one in the way. A dash, B dash, A, B dash, A dash, B, A. This is my problem. Any one or one. Any one means all these three cases will be. One means B is not here, one means one and only one. So I will write it here. Any one means any one. Okay. Probably any one solves the problem with A1. So this may be A solves the problem, B does not solve the problem. A does not solve the problem, B solves the problem. A, B both solves the problem. Okay. Any one. Any one. Any one that is solve one of the problem, like this case.